headset mobile.
Mobile.
Other stuff on social media, but this seems so great because it was a great way to kind of connect with everybody on a more personal level, which was in my control, where I could form perceptions that were in my control and let people into my home through this, because this app is like my home. And I'm really, really happy to see all of you here, and I hope you're enjoying the setup. Yeah, so this is all in my control, and these guys have been so helpful in, you know, making y'all feel comfortable and welcome, because it's welcoming you to our home, and I hope you enjoy us, and we are live! Oh my god! We're live! That's amazing! Hey! Okay, cool. Have you guys already explained everything? Just on the live stream? Okay, so before we start the Q&A or whatever, we decided to not have an MC or a compere or any of those things, because we thought that it's better that we just personally do that. That was Benji's idea. He said we shouldn't have anybody. We should just be here and speak to y'all and not have someone introduce or, you know, talk or anything, because we wanted to connect with you guys. And so before I start about what this app means to me and what it's about, I think I'm going to let Benji and Varun give you an idea of where this comes from and what this app is about. And then I will tell you how this is the most personal thing that I have done till now. Okay.
So like Benji had mentioned earlier, you know, when we first spoke about the potential in India, and then I came down and I looked at a list of, you know, celebrities, and right away, you know, besides me and Sonam being friends, you know, we decided right away she has to be the person, just because, you know, she is so well thought of on social media and on other media as well. We could not really have asked for a better person to do this with in India than Sonam. So more than anything, I'm very humbled, and it's been an amazing experience to work with her so far. We're really looking forward to seeing how this app takes off in the next, you know, coming months and so. Yeah, and we really appreciate all of you coming here and, you know, giving us a chance to really help.
Just a few other points I'd like to say is the piece of technology that we've built for Sonam is 2 years in the making from our tech office in London. And it's almost like we built this piece of technology and then we found the perfect person to partner with Sonam. Over the last few months, we've launched huge global names like Rolling Stones, for example. We've launched the biggest YouTuber in Europe. But for me, the most exciting is Sonam, because she has all the identifiers we have for a client for Decide. She has the audience. She has the desire to interact directly with her audience. So we're enormously excited. So now I'd like to take you through how the app works.
Sorry, before that, I'd just like to say something. We all are actually really proud because, you know, we've been creating history in India. This is the first celebrity app that's come out. And, yeah, I just want to say that we're really looking forward to the future of this app. Thank you.
So the first area in the app is my life. So this is where Sonam.
I'll
explain the technology, so now I'll explain how she's going to use it.
Okay.
So, my life is a timeline of content, so that means it's as she's making it, it's just going into a feed as you'd expect on Facebook, and the fans immediately get a push notification every time she
creates. We call them the tribe, you don't call them the fans.
They're not fans, sorry, they're the tribe.
They're the tribe.
So, the content will come down during the timeline, and obviously the fans can leave comments, they can leave photo responses, they can create memes, they can create GIFs. So Sonam, explain how you see it.
Okay, so my life is a reflection of my life. And I just felt like, you know, with Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, we have everything, but everything is like completely, there's not like a one-point contact where you can get everything. And this is going to have original content. There's going to have stuff. There's this thing that we're working on. We're working on this project called Sister App, where my sister and I and a couple of my girlfriends and maybe like a couple of other girls, we talk about relevant and irrelevant topics. You know, we spoke about Chetan Bhagat, we spoke about Batman versus Superman, we spoke about Disney films, and we were just talking over a glass of wine or over coffee. And that is like almost like a talk show, but it'll be like three minutes. There will be book reviews. I love reading. So I, you know, my likes and dislikes. So I love reading. So every week, most of the time, every week, I'll be putting out a book that I really, really like, and I will review it. It could be like a page review, or it could be three lines, or maybe a selection of five books that I like. So something like that, you know, then and also like Snapchat, I just went to Austria, so I took I've gotten into photography. I'm not really good at it at all, but I'm trying, and all the photographers know I try really hard. I'm trying to give a good picture. I'm going to try and take nice pictures now. So, you know, so my trip in Austria, some of the pictures that I've taken, some of the videos that I've taken, I was doing this ridiculous alkaline diet, which was really, really difficult. I barely lost any weight, but it, you know, it was fun. It was great. So stuff like that, like chronicles of my life. Then, I mean, so it's, you know, and it's a work. I'm gonna keep adding to it. We're gonna, like any other app, we're gonna keep adding to it. We're gonna keep evolving. We're gonna keep making it better. But the kind of comments we are getting, I think people already think my life is kick-ass.
So next we have the live stream, which you had a slightly glitchy first impression of 5 minutes ago. This allows Sonam, from wherever she is, she simply loads up the app, presses one button, and all her fans around the globe will instantly get a push notification saying, Sonam is about to go live.
Sonam is about to go live.
So that means she's there, and fans can click on that and dive in and witness an experience with Sonam in real time. And as I said earlier, also have the ability to share comments and send questions through to Sonam. As soon as that live stream's over, Sonam has the ability to take that live stream and post it onto her timeline for fans to view later.
So this is my favorite part of the app. And I explain to you why. Every other social media platform gives you a chance to edit it. You know, add filters, do this, do that. This is completely unadulterated. It's just me, raw. There will be, and I'm live, I'm right there. I'm like, it's tangible, you know. You can see me, there's no editing. There's nothing, it's right there for everybody to see. And for me, a lot of people say, you know, by joining social media, you lose the mystery of being a star or an actor. You lose the aspirational quality. I don't think that's true. I think you become irrelevant if you're not a part of social media. Because that's the way forward, and also aspirational does not necessarily mean that you need to be out of reach. It just means you stand for ideals and qualities that people look up to and look at and want to follow. And I think by various platforms on social media, including this live stream, people can actually see and follow the good, maybe the bad, sometimes the sad moments, and sometimes maybe the, you know, moment, joyous moments and celebratory moments of my life, and completely unedited and completely raw. And that's why this is one of my favorite parts of, yeah, sort of lying. I'm lying now.
So we now get to my tribe, Sonam's tribe. So a very, very important part of the technology we've built for Sonam is to create the ability for Sonam's tribe all over the world to have their place, their personal place, where they can exchange content with each other, not just content about Sonam. What is the unifying cultural identity that all these fans, these millions of fans around the world, have for Sonam? They can share photos, they can share videos, they can then chat directly and instant message each other. So this becomes a very powerful, thriving community, which is a safe community because it's heavily curated by us. And it will be a warm community and a great place for Sonam's tribe to hang out.
Okay, so I know you guys are thinking, why tribe? I wouldn't call it Sonam's tribe at all, because it's just a tribe. I feel like I don't believe that there are fans anymore in the world. I think there are like-minded people with similar worldviews that are around, and if they feel like you match what they are looking at and look for, then they like to follow your work, they like to follow you on Twitter, they like to follow you on social media, they like to go and see your films. So that becomes like a tribe, it becomes like a community. And for me, that's what it is. So we were going to call it the fan wall, but I was like, I don't know if that works for the people who like my work and who like to follow me on various platforms. And that's why I was like, if they are a part of my tribe, I'm a part of theirs. Because I think we're like-minded people who have the same principles and ideas. And like he said, it's a warm community to kind of interact with each other, to understand each other, to evolve and to communicate. And so that's what it is.
Also, we believe that interaction is a major part of the growth of the app. And one of the really nice features about my tribe is, for example, me and Benji are members of it. We can interact between each other on messages and, talk about Sonam, talk about whatever she's posted or
anything. No, these men look so cute on this white couch.
Sorry, I'm getting tired of this series.
This is Style Mafia. You don't want to say anything about
it? I know nothing about style.
I like the sneakers and the suit look. Everybody knows about my style, and there's been a lot of discussions and there's been a lot of talk about it. And there's a core team that I've been working with since 2007, since I came to this industry, and they're the same people. And we're almost like a mafia. But we're not like the mean kind, we're not mean girls, but it's Namrata Soni, Malika Bhatt, Aarti Nair, there's my sister Ria, there's Tanya Gabri, there's Shireen, there are so many people, there's Karuna, there are various stylists and various makeup artists and hairstylists, there's B-Blank, the whole B-Blank team. There are people who worked on me since the very beginning, especially Namrata Soni and especially my sister Ria. And they will be posting, and I will be posting my various looks, makeup tutorials, hair tutorials, things I'll be posting as well, like the choker. I started wearing this black velvet choker like 3 months ago, and not that I'm saying I'm the first one to wear it, but this was a trend in the 90s when we were all in school, we used to wear those like chokers. And now suddenly everybody's wearing these chokers, so where you can get some of them, I mean, if you've seen the app, then you'll see. So various things, I like to wear round sunglasses. So it'll just be a reflection of my style, of how I create certain looks, how my team creates looks, and we're gonna, start trends, stop trends, try to figure out trends, and so that's what Style Mafia is about. Yeah.
So as I mentioned earlier, an important part of the app is the community aspect. Any fan or tribe member who's in the app can just click on a fan on a profile and immediately become friends with that fan, much like something like WhatsApp. They can create group chats around areas, around particular likes or fascinations, and it's just a great way for fans to be able to connect directly with each other, and they never know, they might get a private message from Sonam one day.
Lots of private messages. But not the shady kind. Okay. Chronicles. Okay, so this has been one of the toughest things for my team and I to put through, is basically archives of everything that I've done since 2007. And I think I need the help of the media to kind of build these archives, because everything that I've ever done is been in front of you guys. Whether it's photo shoots, whether it's events, whether it's magazines, magazine covers, whether it's movies, anything that I've ever done is all out there, and we're trying to collect all of it and archive all of it in my chronicles, basically my life that has been. And instead of calling it the archive, I decided to call it chronicles, because these are chronicles of my life. This is what has, I've grown up in front of you guys. I've been in this industry since I was 17 years old, working in this industry. So everything that has ever happened has been in front of yours, good, bad, and ugly, me saying stupid stuff, sensible stuff, stuff that doesn't make any sense, stuff that makes a lot of sense. So all of that is going to go there, and I would request you all to send me more stuff so that I can archive, so all the people who are downloading this app and who have this app, if they want to see what is in my life, I mean, that's why they're downloading this app, they can find it all in the Chronicles. We've tried to do as much as we can, but it's, like I said, since we're still building it, we're still adding content, it's always going to keep, it's going to keep developing, it's going to keep evolving.
So that's the run through of the app.
What about the workaholic?
Oh, we didn't put workaholic,
no,
but you can explain that. Explain
okay.
That.
So there's another section called workaholic. Like alcohol, I'm a workaholic. Like I said, I don't have a personal life. Everybody knows that. Nobody ever writes about it. I don't have a personal life, but the work that I do makes me Sonam, and it makes me who I am. And whether it's behind the scenes, whether it's blogs that I've done during my films, whether it's my posters, my teasers, my trailers, interviews with my directors, interviews with my co-stars, everything will go into workaholic. I tried to do a vlog during Nija, but I couldn't do it. I did a couple and then I just stopped. But my next film, which I'm going to announce very, very soon, will have vlogs of me every day, and I'm going to collect those, and those will go into workaholic. It's about how I've created my character, how I've sat with the director. So there will be behind the scenes, obviously, there will be the making of, all the usual stuff that every other film does, every other actor does, but this will be different, because it will be... Have you guys seen Avatar? I call it Avatar because I'm Indian, not Avatar, like everybody else. But there, he'd done vlogs about his daily, whatever was happening daily, and I think even as actors, I think it's really great, even if it was 5 seconds, just sit and go through the day or before you're preparing. So that kind of stuff is gonna be on workaholic. We're trying really, really hard to do that. And I mean, you guys are gonna keep like getting new content to even write about. So I won't be getting calls, we need a story. So this is gonna be good. That's the making of. That's Nija's making of.
That's the workaholic section.
And that's the behind the scenes of making of. Did you like the video that we did? The launch video where I was going mad, where Swara and Atul, who I surprisingly is a very good actor, and my sister and everybody else thought that I was going crazy. So that's the behind the scenes of that, and my sister and everybody else. And that's Radhika, that's my fitness trips. That's Radhika, who's my nutritionist and trainer. And she is also going to give fitness trip tips. She's going to be flying with me to Cannes this year. And she flies every year with me. Those are my favorite cupcakes that my friend Pooja Nira does for Lakant, La 15 Patisserie. You guys will be having her lovely cupcakes today. So she's given us the recipe. And those are the Disney films. Because I saw Jungle Book and it was awesome. So I decided, like, I thought about all my like old Disney films that I've watched. And since I happened to be the first Disney actress in India, I was really modest, and I put my own Disney film there as well. So all that stuff. So I'm quite excited, and those are people. Normal people are putting up gifts and stuff like that. So yeah, thank you guys. And any questions? Okay. Hi. Do you like it? Thank you. I mean, how candid am I? Yeah, so it's going to be a reflection of who I am.
Okay, and where do you think you'll be getting your inspiration from? Is it only the films, or are you going to be looking beyond it?
I'm going to be doing everything that makes me me. So films is a large part of who I am, but it's also going to be fashion, it's going to be books, it's going to be food, it's going to be travel, it's going to be my girls, it's going to be my friends, it's going to be the people I work with, who also happen to be my best friends. It's going to be lots of stuff. It's going to be lots and lots of stuff. It's going to be, you know, pretty and warm and inspirational, and I'm going to try my very, very best to make it as interesting and as interactive and as cool as I can make it. Yeah, thank you.
Hi Sonam, this is Nawaz from Stardust.
Hi.
So the app is really stylish. It looks very great.
Thank you.
And I think so.